no matter what I have to do, 'cause I need you more and more. I'm chasing after you, no matter what I have to do, 'cause I need you, Lord, more and more. I'm chasing after you, no matter what I have to do, 'cause I need you more and more. I'm chasing after you, no matter what I have to do, 'cause I need you more and more.
Some God chaser.
Yes, hallelujah. After you.
Yeah.
I'm praising my way through.
We gotta
just
get closer. Lord, we're chasing.
I'm chasing,
yeah,
after you.
More and more.
More and more.
More and more.
More and more.
We need you more and more.
More and more.
Gotta have you more and more, yeah.
More and more.
Come on, somebody let and release a shout of praise, a victory tonight in the house. Hallelujah. Come on, if you know you don't serve no weak, puny, pathetic God, come on, raise up a shout to him tonight. Hallelujah. We bless you, God. It's all because of you that we're here tonight. Oh, it's because of you we gathered here to give you praise and glory and honor. Oh, God, we lift our hands, we lift our voices and praise you. Hallelujah. Come on, oh, clap your hands, everybody. Yeah. Come on, he deserves our best this evening. Oh, come on, inhabit this place, God. You're worthy of the glory. Yes, you are. Come on, everybody, let's sing it. Every time I lift my...
Every time I lift my hands, it's because of you.
Come on, you got it.
Every time I lift my voice, it's because of you.
Come on, that's it.
Sing. Every time I give you praise, it's because of you.
Come on, every time that we bless him, it's because.
Every time I bless your name, oh, it's because,
yeah,
of you.
Come on, sing it again every time.
Every time I lift my hands, it's because of you.
Come on, as a sign of surrender, it's in praise.
Every time I lift my voice, it's because of you.
Oh, yes, come on, somebody give him praise tonight.
Every time I give you praise, it's because of you.
Come on, let's bless him together
every
with one voice. Hallelujah.
Your name, it's because of you.
Come on, tell him tonight.
It's because of you that I sing. It's because of you that I pray. It's because of you that I worship and bow down to your name.
Come on, tell him it's all.
It's because of you that I dance.
Hallelujah.
It's because of you that I shout. It's because of you that I leap for joy with a heart that has no doubt.
Sing every time.
Every time I lift my hands, it's because of you.
Come on, offer up surrenderance to him.
Every time I lift my voice, it's because of you.
Hallelujah. Come on, he wants all of you tonight. Offer up praise.
Every time I give you praise, it's
we'll
because
love you,
of
we'll
you.
We love you. Yes, we do. Come on and bless him.
Every time I bless your name, it's because of you.
Come on, sing again. Every time.
Every time I lift my hands, it's because of you.
Come on, he's the reason, amen? Yes.
Every time I lift my voice, it's because of you.
Every time.
Every time I give you praise, it's because of you.
Come on, let's bless him and say it.
Every time I bless your name, it's because of you.
Come on, it's all because of him.
It's because of you that I sing. It's because of you that I pray.
Come on, God, we worship.
It's because of you that I worship and bow down to your name every day.
Come on, we're free to dance in his presence.
It's because of you that I dance.
Oh.
It's because of you that I shout. It's because of you that I leap for joy in a heart that has no doubt.
Sing every time.
Every time I lift my hands, it's because of you.
Yes, it is. Say it.
Every time I lift my voice, it's because of you.
Hallelujah.
Sing. Every time I give you praise, it's because of you.
Come on, be a vessel of praise tonight right here.
Sing. Every time I bless your name, it's because of you.
Come on, sing it again. Every time, Lord.
Every time I lift my hands, it's because of you.
Come on, be free to praise and press on in his presence.
Every time I lift my voice, it's because
of you. Oh,
you're
worthy. We give you praise, Lord.
Every time I give you praise, it's because of you.
Come on, somebody bless him the best way you know how.
Every time I bless your name, it's because of you.
Come on, here we go. Come on, raise it up.
It's because of you that I sing. It's because of you that I pray. It's because calls on you that I worship and bow down to your name every day.
It's always
because of you that I dance. It's because of you that I shout. It's because of you that I leap for joy.
Come on, sing it, please.
It's because of you that I sing
praise.
It's because of you that I pray. It's because of you that I worship and bow down to your name every day.
Say,
it's because of you that I dance. It's because of you that I shout.
Raise my shout. It's because of you
that I leap for joy with the heart that come on, somebody
say it again.
It's because of you that I sing. It's because of you, Jesus.
Yes, it is.
It's because of you that I worship and bow down to your name every day. It's because of you that I dance. It's because of you that I shout. It's because of you that
come on, play it one time.
Joy with a heart that has no doubt.
Come on, somebody, just bless the Lord tonight. Come on in your own way. Come on, be free to lift up Jesus. You're so worthy, Lord. You're so because of you. Come on, Judah, sing it.
Well, it's because of you that I sing.
It's because of you, you alone.
It's because of you that I worship and bow down.
Just to your worship your name.
It's because of you that I dance. It's because of you that I shout. Because of you that I leap for joy with a heart that has no doubt.
Yes. Oh, come on, somebody raise a shout to him. Yes, he's worthy in this place. Oh, yes, he is. Hallelujah. Ah, come on, the reason we're here tonight, it ain't so you can hear us or you can see us. It ain't so we can see our bishop. It's first to see and have an encounter. Come on, with Jesus, our Savior this evening. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody right now, be obedient. Be a vessel of worship. Be a vessel of praise for him right now. He's worthy. Come on, if you want him in your midst, give him something to inhabit right now. Come on, he loves to hear the praises of his people going up. Oh, we bless you, Lord. Come on, there's nothing that our God cannot do. There's nothing too impossible, no match for him. So we bless you tonight. Come on, play it again. Father, we love you. There's nothing that you can do. Nothing too hard for you, no. We love you, Jesus. Come on, do you believe we serve a God of miracles tonight? Hallelujah. Come on, let your faith rise tonight. Oh, we love you, Jesus. Oh. Water you turn into wine. You have opened the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you. Come on, nobody else. None like you. Thank you, Lord, that into the darkness you shine. Come on, he's the light of the world. Out of these ashes we rise. There's no one like you. No, none like you. Come on, everybody, sing water.
Water, you turn into wine.
You can do it.
Open the eyes of the
there's
blind.
No one.
There's no one like you.
No, there's no one like you. No,
none like you. Into the darkness,
that's
you
where you shine. Hallelujah.
Come out of the ashes, we rise.
Come on, we
there's
are the
no one like you.
Through Jesus tonight, there's
none like you.
No one like you. Sing our God.
Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. Lord, you are higher than any.
Our God
other.
Is greater.
Our God is healer.
He
is awesome in power. Our God.
Oh, come on and lift him up.
Our God.
Say it again, our God. For our God
is greater. And our God is stronger. Lord, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer.
Awesome in power.
Awesome in power. Our God.
He is my.
Our God.
Come on, can you claim him as your own tonight? Hallelujah.
You're our God. Sing water you turn.
Water you turn into wine.
I believe you can still open the eyes of the blind.
Of the blind.
For there's no one like you. Oh, none can compare.
None like you.
You alone are worthy into.
Into the darkness you shine.
Come on, into a dark world he can shine.
Out of the ashes we rise.
There's no
one like you.
Hallelujah. Somebody say none like
none
you.
Like you.
Oh, our God
is greater.
Come on.
Our God is stronger. Lord, you are higher than any.
Our God is
healer.
He's awesome in
awesome
power, yeah.
Power,
he's our God. Come on, claim it.
Our God.
Sing it again, our God.
Oh, our God is greater.
And our God is stronger.
Lord,
come on, show yourself strong and
mighty. Oh, yeah. Our God is healer.
He's awesome.
Awesome in
he's
power.
He's an awesome God, yeah. Our God. Come on, somebody be aware of his presence tonight. Hallelujah. Yes, you're here. Oh, water you turn into wine.
Water you turn into wine.
Oh, you've
opened the eyes of the blind.
Do it again, Lord.
There's no one like
you. Oh, do it, Lord. There's
none like you.
Come on, sing it into.
Into the darkness you shine.
Oh, he can shine. Come on to it, Lord.
Out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you.
Come on, none can compare.
None like you.
Come on, he's in a class all by himself. For our God is greater.
Our God is stronger. Lord, you are higher than any. Other. Our God is healer.
Lord, he can be your healer when you need
power.
Our God. Come on, sing it again tonight.
Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. Lord, you are higher than any other.
Come on, brag on your God tonight.
God
come on, brag
healer.
On it. Yes.
Awesome in power, God.
Yes,
our God.
Hallelujah. Come on, somebody magnify him and who he is tonight. Come on, as we sing this part together. And if
our God is for us, then who could ever stop us?
Come on, that's what his word says.
And if our God is with us,
you can take him at his word. Yes, you can.
And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop
come
us?
On, do it, Lord.
And if our God is with
do
us,
it, Lord.
Then what can stand
come on, say it
against
again.
And if our God is for
come on, he fights for you on your behalf. Hallelujah.
And if our God is with us, then what can stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us?
Come on, you're getting it tonight.
And if our God is
say it again.
Then what can stand against? And if our God is for us,
oh, come on, I know he's for us.
Who could ever stop
us?
And if our God is with us, then what can stand
come on, say it again.
And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand?
Come on, say it with us.
And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us?
Come on, church, declare it for yourself.
And if our God is with us,
yes,
what can stand against?
Say again.
And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us?
Come on, he's on our side, yeah.
And if our God is with us, then what can stand against?
And if our God is for us,
then who could ever stop us?
Oh, come on.
And if our God is with us,
I want you to just lift your voice and say it tonight.
And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us?
Come on, let it sound like an anthem in this place. Come on, a war cry, a shout.
Oh, yeah. And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us?
If our God is with us,
oh,
Come on. There's nobody greater.
Yes. And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand?
Say it again.
And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand?
Say it one more time.
And if our God is for us,
yes,
then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand against?
Oh, come on, somebody, build yourself up tonight. Trust in the Lord.
Then what can stand against?
Hallelujah. Come on, I want you to raise your voice strong tonight. Sing it, our God is greater.
Our God is greater.
And our God is stronger.
Lord, you are higher than any other.
Our God is
He's
a healer.
Awesome and power.
He's our God. He's our God.
Our God.
Sing it one more time, yeah.
Our God is greater.
And our God is stronger.
Lord, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer.
He's awesome in every way.
Power, our God. Our God.
Oh, he's our God. He's my God. I claim him as my own. Come on. I am his and he is mine. Hallelujah. Come on, that'll encourage yourself no matter how you might be feeling. Come on, that you belong to the Creator. You belong to the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. Oh, we bless and magnify your name. Show yourself strong and mighty in this place, oh God. Hallelujah. Oh God, we bless you tonight. Oh, we want to see you do great and mighty things, Father. You're an amazing God. Hallelujah. We bless you tonight, God. Come on, I want somebody tonight, I want you to put your mouth where your faith is tonight. Come on and express to the Lord. Yeah. Well, come on and bless him in the house. Come on, let's sing together.
Oh,
oh, oh, oh, Lord.
Heaven, oh, heaven on earth.
Show yourself. Is upon me, for his anointing is empowering. The kingdom of the Lord is within me, and he is calling me to the heavenlies, oh,
to be seated in heavenly places, just like heaven. Just like heaven.
Come on, sing
on
to be walking.
To be walking in his favor and grace.
It's
just like heaven on earth. Whoa, whoa.
We won't experience your glory.
Heaven on earth.
Yeah.
Whoa, whoa.
Come on, release a sound in this place.
Heaven.
Sounding like heaven. Marching in the spirit of unity to our community, show his ability. Oh, the will of the Lord for his children is to demonstrate, perpetuate, oh,
be seated in heavenly places, just like heaven. Just like heaven on earth,
to be walking in his favor and grace is just like heaven on earth.
Just like heaven on earth.
Sing,
oh,
come on, cry out to the true and living God.
Heaven on earth.
Don't withhold nothing, God, from us.
Heaven.
Oh, yes, come on. Something's moving, something's changing. See his glory, feels like heaven on earth.
Something's moving, something's changing.
Come on, your mic can't see it.
See his glory,
feels like heaven on earth.
Oh, something's moving.
Come on, see it in the spirit tonight.
Changed. Oh, see His glory.
Feels like heaven on earth.
Something's moving. Something's changing. See His glory.
Feels like heaven on earth.
Something's moving.
Come on, change it around.
Something's changing.
Do a shift, God. Do a shift, God.
Feels like heaven on earth.
Something's moving. Something's changing. See His glory. Feels like heaven on earth.
There is lightning and thunder, miracles and wonders, the sounds of many waters.
Heaven on earth,
lightning and thunder.
Oh, come on, speak it, church. Come on, speak it from out of your mouth.
Heaven on earth, oh, lightning and thunder, miracles and wonders, sounds of many waters. The sounds of many waters.
There's
lightning and thunder, miracles and wonders. The sounds of many waters.
Sing, whoa, whoa, whoa. Calling for you to come higher, see everything from a new point of view, to be seated with Jesus in heavenly places. From His perspective, everything is made new. Heaven is calling for us to go higher, to see everything from His point of view, to be seated with Jesus in heavenly places. From His perspective, everything is made new. There is lightning and thunder, miracles and wonders, the sounds of many waters. Heaven on earth,
lightning and thunder, miracles and wonders.
Bring healing in your presence, God. Yeah.
Heaven on earth.
Say lightning and thunder.
Oh, touch us, God.
Miracles and wonders.
The sounds of many waters.
Heaven on earth.
Lightning and thunder. Miracles and wonders. The sounds of many waters.
Oh, one more time.
Lightning and thunder. Miracles and wonders, the sound of many waters,
heaven on
sing
earth.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Heaven,
oh yeah,
heaven on earth,
oh, heaven.
Whoa, whoa,
whoa,
heaven.
Oh, something's moving, something's changing. Your glory.
Hallelujah.
Your glory.
Am I the only one in here? Hallelujah. Y'all do know church started at 6:30, right?
Lord,
y'all do know this ain't
Lord,
rehearsal, right?
Do
you do know we're changing the atmosphere, right? You do know something's moving. You do know something's changing. It's got to change in the spiritual before it changes in the natural. It's got to change in places you can't see before it changes in places you can see. Remember I told you this morning, if you ain't sowing anything up, don't be expecting nothing to come down. Have you sown up a praise tonight? Well, three of you have. God bless you. I said, have you sown up a praise tonight? I can't hear you. Lord, have mercy. Everybody just stand up with me. If you, I see some folks have babies asleep. We ain't gonna mess with you, not one little bit. You stay there and do what you need to do. God bless you. I understand it. If you ain't feeling all that right now, that's all right. You ain't got to force yourself up either. But I want everybody that can, I want you to get up right now, and I want you to tell somebody there's some changing going on. Tell them there's some changing going on. There's some changing going on. some changing going on. Hallelujah. I'm going to ask our ushers, if you would, to come on. I'm going to make show up good tonight. I just feel like being a little mischievous. Is it all right? Well, I am anyway. All right, everybody get your offering now. Everybody get your offering. We're gonna let you bring it. Okay, everybody, I want everybody to move. Unless you got a lap child, a sleeping baby, or you just, you know what, you can't move. I want everybody else to move. And listen to me. When you go back, I don't want you to go back in your same seat. I know that hurts somebody's feelings because you are connected to that seat. I want you to get closer to me. Okay, I feel like I have to wait. Hey, that's all right if it's on. But tonight I need you up here. Okay, because we got to feed off each other a little bit in here. Is that all right? That all right?
Yeah.
Now if you're gonna get mad and go on back and be rebellious, then God bless you. You ain't getting nothing tonight anyway till you get over your rebellious self. Come on, smile at me. I want you to go in a different direction. You ain't got to be crazy and from this side to that side. But everybody kind of just get a little bit closer, all right? All right, amen. We're going to see if you can take instruction or not. Amen, because it's all about what you can get out of this word. It's instruction tonight I'm giving you. Lord, y'all moving already. Praise God. Come on, let's bring our offering. Would you bring your tithe, your offering? Everybody come. Everybody bring something. If you ain't got nothing, come touch the basket. I dare you to touch it and say, I'll catch you next week. Maybe you done run out of money. You tell them, I'll be caught up next week. There's a miracle coming. Hallelujah. Sing that again, will you?
Something's moving. Something's changing.
And don't go back in that
see
same seat now.
Glory.
Move a little bit. A little bit closer. A little closer.
Moving.
Just a little closer.
Something's changing. See His glory. Feels like heaven on earth. Something's moving. Something's changing. See His glory, feels like heaven on earth. Something's moving, something's changing.
Come on.
See His glory, feels like heaven on earth. Something's moving, something's changing. See His glory, feels like heaven on earth. Something's moving, something's changing. See His glory. Feels like heaven on earth. Something's moving.
Raise your hands.
Something's changing. See His glory. Feels like heaven on earth. Something's moving. Something's changing. See His glory. Feels like heaven on earth.
Now you think I'm just trying to do something. I wanted to use that song to try to teach you. Just a little lesson, okay? Are you looking at me? Until you change, don't expect things to change. So I just had you change seats. You see how that mess? Some of y'all you drug your pocketbook down. No, it wasn't that bad. It wasn't that bad. But you see, you changed, okay? Sometimes you got to change before you can change something else. It ain't that hard. Y'all, sometimes a little change can do a whole lot of good. Lord, if some of y'all would have gotten closer, you'd have been up here in my pocket. But thank you, Jesus, for moving. Let Judah know you appreciate their ministry. Amen. And do one more thing. Let's thank Brother Chris and his beloved wife, the Bostics, for being here doing an awesome job today. Yay. You may be seated. Amen, amen, amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Got a word for you tonight. I want you to get it. Okay? So right now, I want you to forget about the birthday party. Did y'all come for cake? If you did, and I need to serve you cake right now so you can get it out of the way and hear the word of the Lord. I will mess with you. There's more back there than cake. There's 100 and some cupcakes, and there is homemade punch and there is shrimp kebabs. Yea, I say unto thee, hurry up and preach. There is fried chicken and drummies and wings and corn and meatballs and... Ha! That ain't the Holy Ghost y'all hearing. That's my belly growling. So we're gonna honor First Lady. After everybody's welcome. Just come on back. There's plenty of food. We're going to have a great time. And in advance, let me thank those that have worked so hard to prepare. Some of our folks, they're having to watch it through the television tonight in the back in order to accommodate on this special occasion. Two Sunday nights from tonight. That's July the 12th. We're not calling off service. We're just relocating. We're going to hook up with Bryn Waddell, Truth Temple. Dr. Lowry will be there, and I'm gonna call him and tell him, save me a seat. I'm going to be there. I go, and I want to take as many Praising Place people as I can so you can see a little bit of where I got what I got from an impartation from him. And it's certainly, every chance he's close by, I need to be there because he's in his mid-80s, I'm guessing. When God calls Elijah, Elisha wants to be ready to catch it. You know what I'm saying? So I want to be there. So we invite you to do that. If you have your Bibles, I'm going to take you to two passages out of the same book. We'll do a little bit of teaching and direction for you tonight. Okay? Still part of our increase. I told you everywhere I look now, in all of my reading, all of my study, I'm seeing increase. Increase, increase. Elijah performed 16 miracles. Elisha 32. Everywhere I look, I'm seeing increase. And I'm seeing that the latter ought to be greater. And the end of the thing ought to be greater. The church should not be declining. We should not be decreasing. We should be increasing. I told you this morning, I ain't mad at people with the Supreme Court decision. I can't even be mad at them people. Sinners do what sinners do. I'm mad at church people. And particularly preachers that let it get this bad. That would not preach the word. Didn't define what sin was. Didn't set the atmosphere for conviction in the house. People can't get convicted if you don't tell them what they need to be convicted of. Amen? Amen. We are difference makers. And I believe the glory of the Lord is going to cover the earth as waters cover the sea. I told my wife, I said, I just hope they get a better and get a people. God will do a mighty thing. Do you believe it? You'll be hearing more about that. It's just all up in me. I want to teach you tonight and help you. And try to bring some clarification as to why some of you are going through what you're going through, and prepare others that you're about to go into some stuff. You don't know it, but there is a meeting going on right now. Satan has called some henchmen, and they're discussing some of you. Believe you, huh? We're going to find out. I don't know where y'all got your training from, but I'm going to fix it tonight. Job chapter 23, verse number 10. But he knoweth, God knows. The preceding verses, he said, I don't know where God is. He said, I look to the left, he's not there. I look to the right, he's not there. I don't know where God is. He said, but when I don't know where he is, he knows where I am. He said, the Lord knows the way that I take, and when he has tried me, I will come forth as pure gold. How many of you know something golden is coming at the end of this mess? I don't see any hands. I don't want you depressed when I talk about trouble and trial. I don't want you depressed because this is going to make you better. God's not allowing this to go on in your life to punish you. God's allowing this to prepare you, to perfect you. Next verse, please. Job chapter 42, verses 16 and 17 here. After this, somebody say, after this. Tell somebody, this ain't all it is. This ain't all it is, baby. After this, lived Job 140 more years. Trouble didn't stop him. Trouble didn't kill him. Lean over and tell your neighbor, you're going to outlive this. I can tell some of y'all don't believe that, so I'm going to go on over here. He outlived this 140 years and saw his sons and his son's sons and his son's son's sons. Yeah, I believe Job just got tired of writing, and he said, under four generations. You know what that means? That means he saw his sons, he saw his grandkids, he saw his great-grandkids, he saw his great-great-grandkids. There was a time when he sat on an ash heap, and he thought, this is it. His wife said, you're on your way out. Curse God and die. You ain't coming out of this anyway. If you curse God, he'll end your misery. He'll take you out now. He said, you talk like a foolish woman. And he outlived it. Oh, let me tell you, this message ain't really for y'all tonight. This message is for the devil. The title of the message is, Devil, You Gonna Pay for This. Come on. I know the devil talks to you, but every once in a while you need to talk back to him. I want somebody to shout real loud, Devil, you gonna pay for this. You thought I had a praise before? You ain't seen how I can praise. You thought I had a dance before this? You wait till I'm done. I'll be taking two pews at a time. Devil, you gonna pay for this. Of course, you know that I am a proud poppy. Hey, Alana. Wave at me. Wave. In case y'all don't know, that's little Alana. She is... Look at there. She's wanting to come to her poppy. Y'all look back there, how pretty. There she is trying to climb down off of Nana's lap. God bless you, honey. You got your hands full. I shouldn't have called her out. But, you know, just you know, time sort of stands still, you know. And everything seems to be a photographic moment. You know, you file it away in your mind. Not just the laughing and the giggling and the climbing and the adventuresome spirit, but even watching her sleep. I'm watching her sleep one day, and I'm watching, I guess doctors would call it some rapid eye movement. And I'm watching the eyes go back and forth, and then it made me start to realize she's looking at something in her sleep. You know, there's different realms of sleep, right? How many of you know when you hit that is it the third realm? Come on, I pray to God you don't hit it right now, but somewhere tonight I hope you get into that third realm. And usually in that third realm, you are in a deep sleep, right? And there's something going on. Seems like in my deepest sleep, I am dreaming. And of course, we've all had those pleasant, peaceful dreams, right? Even some dreams, we would consider them to be fantasies. Has anybody ever dreamed you were flying? Anybody ever dreamed you were falling? Felt real, didn't it? Ain't it amazing? You get a feel with your dreams, and it's real, Lord. Hey, you wake up and you feel like you did dunk that basketball. Come on, y'all. You feel like you did score the game-winning touchdown. I remember, since it's First Ladies, we're celebrating her birthday, I remember waking up one morning, and she looked at me, and she said, I could slap you. I said, what? She said, I dreamed last night you cheated on me. And I don't know why she dreamed that. I didn't give her any cause to dream that. Maybe she, you know, hey, she ate something late at night, or I don't know. Ask her. I'm not going to make excuses. Ask her. But she said, that seemed surreal until I could have slapped you. She said, I looked at you and you sleeping, but I got mad at you. Have you ever had a dream that seems so real? My. But watch, while we would call these dreams, and there are dreams that leave us feeling peaceful and tranquil and somewhat euphoric, there are some other dreams that we would categorize them as being nightmares. And nightmares pretty much play on our fears, things that we dread. In fact, I read in the story of Job where he said, the thing that I greatly feared, feared. Somebody say feared. The thing that I greatly feared has come upon me. But watch, even though we are people that are apt to be emotional, we feel like sometimes we are getting sometimes a sense of what could be coming. You know, and it feels so bad because of the dream or because of the news or whatever. And then we try to take some precautionary measures because the dream or the nightmare made us feel so bad. We can only anticipate what reality would do to us emotionally. So we began to take out insurance. We take out automobile insurance in case we wreck. We take out health insurance in case we get sick. We take out life insurance in case there is a death. We take out disability insurance. We take out unemployment insurance. And here's what we do in an attempt to escape trouble, or at least somehow sort of deaden the blow, we arm ourselves with blue crosses and blue shields. We go to the Allstate folk and talk to the Good Hands people. We try to get Nationwide on our side. Yeah. But in spite of all of these human efforts, trouble is going to come. Whoever told you that you would not have trouble as a child of God told you a bald-faced lie. In fact, sometimes when you have your name written in the Lamb's Book of Life, you become a target. You become a hunted individual. Satan puts you on his hit list. Watch this. Job 14 verse 1. Man that is born of a woman is a few days and full of trouble. In fact, 15 to 5, I'm putting in some more verses for you. Watch this. Psalm 34, 9. Many are the afflictions even of the righteous. Jesus said in John 14, 33, in this world you're going to have tribulation. Listen to 1 Peter 4, 12. Beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial that is to try you as though some strange thing happened. Chapter 1, verse 7 talks about the trying of your faith that is more precious than gold that perishes. Listen to Paul, who knew quite a bit about suffering, as he writes to his son Timothy in 2 Timothy 3 and 12. He said, they that live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. Philippians 1, 29. He says, for unto you it is given on the behalf of Christ, not only to believe on him, but to suffer for his sake. Yeah. 1 Corinthians 13, every man's work shall be manifest, for the day shall declare it, because it shall be revealed by fire. For the fire shall try every man's work to see what sort it is. Every man builds on some kind of foundation, whether it's gold or silver, or whether it's wood, or whether it's stubble. But the Bible said that the fire will tell us what you're made of. Help me, Lord Jesus. You don't know if you can take it or not until it hits you full force. And then we will know if you are built on the shifting sands of time, or you are built on the solid rock of Jesus Christ. Somebody shout yes. I don't want you to depress anybody, but tell them trouble comes. I appreciate all that enthusiasm. Trouble is a universal traveler. It doesn't matter how much money you make, how educated you are, how well you are liked, doesn't matter how spiritual you are, trouble is going to come. And people react differently. When trouble comes, some get bitter, some get better. When trouble comes, watch, some are built up and some are broken down. When trouble comes, some are refined and some are confined. When trouble comes, some are restricted while others are released. What you have to know is that trouble, listen to me, does not come. And I ain't talking about, listen, I ain't talking about these little minute bumps. And I'm talking about a hellacious attack. Do you know the difference? Listen, do you know the difference between life and hell has broke out against you? You sense it. me see the hands of those of you that's spiritual enough to know. Come on, when there ain't no more, you know, it's just they run out of milk because it's getting ready to snow kind of stuff. You want to blame the devil on that? No, that ain't. Come on, I'm talking about real stuff. So what I want to show you is that everybody's going to have some trouble. People are going to react differently. But very few people come to the understanding as to why it happened. Some think, well, it's just my time or just my turn. They think that the devil has this big lottery tumbler and he got everybody's name and he just on any given day can pull out your name and your address. Brothers and sisters, I believe that there are cold-blooded, maniacal, seasonal, strategic attacks that the enemy keeps until we're about to step in to our destiny. I think that there's some things that the devil keeps on ice. Come on, help me here. He keeps them on ice. He keeps them on reserve. And he releases them as strategic points in our life. Sometimes we instigate and initiate our own suffering through rebellion. Help me, somebody. Through disobedience. Look at me. God is not mocked. What a man sows, that shall he also reap. Make your bed, you're going to lay in it. Lay down with dogs, you get up with. Come on, help me. I got a lot of these I would give you. If you do the crime, you're going to do the time. But there are some things that we did not bring on ourselves. There are some things that come because you did something stupid. Come on. You did something that was adolescent. You made some dumb, boneheaded decision and move, and now you're suffering consequences. But there are things that come because not that you did something wrong, but you've been doing something right. And the devil comes to test you. He comes to pick a fight to see what you're made of. The truth is, trouble is not our adversary. Trouble is the sign that we have an adversary. And oftentimes, our adversary knows better than we know that we are called, that we are appointed, that we are chosen people. And anointed, help me. And he comes to derail us. He comes to sabotage us. He comes because he knows you're about to walk in to the fullness of God's promise for your life. And if he don't stop you now, preach to y'all because these folks done left me. If he don't stop you now, he won't be able to stop you at all. It is Pharaoh trying to kill Moses because he knows there's a deliverer coming. And they've got to put Moses in a basket. It is Herod trying to kill Jesus. He don't know a lot, but he knows there's a king coming. Are you listening to me? It is Joseph's brothers knowing there is a prince in there somewhere. And if we don't stop him now, there'll be no stopping him. It is seen in the story of Job, because Job said, I was the eyes to the blind. I was the legs to the lame. He said, I was a man that had influence. So what the enemy is trying to do is stop your influence. Tell your neighbor, this is just a sign that I'm about there. If we ever learn to embrace the battle, one of these days I may preach a message when God takes the sting out of the fight. In fact, I've been praying a little bit and kind of thinking I might start another series in 2016 when I finish this one, entitled, I'm in a fight, but I'll be all right. Let me walk you through some things. In the story of the book of Job, God pulls back the veil.
Okay? He allows us to eavesdrop on a conversation between God and Satan. It shows us the precursor, the prelude, as well as the aftermath. It shows us the before the battle and after the victory. Oh, Lord. Notice when you crack open the story of Job's life, you find the devil walking in. Listen, brothers and sisters, let me identify for you the real devil. Because society and the devil, or the world, has tried to soften up the devil. Don't really want to show you and me all that the devil is after. Because when he shows up, he is some cartoonish-like figure. Come on. He you know, he's almost this little cute, cuddly buffoon. Come on, help me, y'all. He's got pointed ears, pointed tail, and a pitchfork. He's just waiting around the corner to say, boo, gotcha. And when they show us, when Hollywood does a pictorial of any demonic activity, all you see the devil doing is slamming doors and taking pictures off the wall. I want to tell you, it's a whole lot different than that. If you think that the devil is just after rearranging your furniture, you don't know the devil of the Bible. He don't give a hoot or a holler about the devil's after my car. He ain't after your car. He ain't after your house. There is a bigger target. He is ultimately after your soul. And listen, there are those of us seated here tonight. The devil knows he ain't getting your soul. The devil knows he ain't getting my soul. Oh no, I come through too many battles and trugged through too many trials and tribulations and valleys. I prayed too many prayers, shed too many tears, oh, for me to walk out of this thing now. If I fall 7 times, I'll just keep getting up. So he knows he ain't gonna get my soul. So if he can't get my soul, he'll get my faith. Because without faith, I won't be able to make it through life. I'll struggle, and I'll always be behind the eight ball, and I'll always be down and out, discouraged. I'll always have my tail tucked between my legs. But if I can keep my faith will help me climb out, overcome, tunnel through. Somebody shout yes. When you see Hollywood portray demonic activity, they're always ghastly, gruesome, and grotesque. Okay? Always got fangs and, you know, zits and, come on, boils and, you know, slimy stuff all over them. You need to read your Bible. The Bible says that he's as an angel of light. The Bible tells me that he was beautiful until his heart was lifted up because of his own beauty. Let me walk you through it in the book of Genesis. The law first mentioned, when you see it the first time, it carries theme throughout the entire Bible. The Bible said that the serpent was subtle. Subtle means cunning. It means crafty. People talk about the devil being stupid. The devil ain't stupid. The devil is smart. Come on, watch me. The Bible says he's subtle. Ephesians 6:11 talks about the wiles of the devil. Wiles means the schemes of the devil. It means that he is sneaky, that he is underhanded. Look at me, brothers and sisters. The devil don't play fair. No. The devil don't go by the rules. Satan and his henchmen. Let me teach you tonight. Satan and his henchmen, they are like con men. And the reason that the con man is successful is he plays on the ignorance of the victim. And when Satan comes in Genesis, he is testing Eve out to see how much word she has. Because when he comes, he says, hath God God said. He said, I want to find out how much words you got in you. The Bible says that he comes as a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour. Brothers and sisters, when the enemy comes, first of all, he will prod. He will check. He will send out some feelers because he wants to find out how deeply rooted you are in the Bible. And the Bible said we are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Paul said, if you are ignorant, you give the devil the upper hand in this warfare. So the devil, he seeks out the uneducated. I'm not talking about scholastically. I'm talking about spiritually. You know who he's coming after? He's coming after those of you that you ain't read your Bible in a month. Well, I've depressed us all. The devil is not omnipresent. He's not everywhere. How many of you know he ain't everywhere? Okay? He ain't everywhere. He works through a network of demons. He is the brains. They are the brawn. The devil has order. Jesus, now please, this is the only way I know how to put it, paid him sort of a compliment when he said, Satan's kingdom is not divided. If his house were divided, it could not stand. Listen, Satan works through channels. Ephesians calls it principalities and powers, the rulers of the darkness of this world, spiritual wickedness in high places. There are local devils, there are territorial and regional devils, there are national demons. Come on, the prince of Persia. Come on, people, help me here. I'm trying to educate you. There's demons that control regions and territories, and they have underlings that work at their disposal. People talking about the devil came to my room. The devil ain't got you to study. He didn't come to your room. He sent one of his punks. Oh, God have mercy. He works. And the reason the church is not able to fight is because you can't fight order with disorder. Am I helping? Watch. The Bible talks about seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. This is the acceptance of wrong for being right. The enemy, we see it now, don't we? Brainwashing people. Matthew 24:24. For there shall arise false Christs and false prophets, and shall do great signs and wonders, insomuch that, if it were possible, the very elect would be deceived. Watch. So Satan comes to check your word knowledge. He comes to Jesus. Come on. And the Bible said he uses the Bible. He goes all the way to Deuteronomy and tries to use the word on the guy that wrote the book. Jesus said, it is written, it is written, it is, you better know your book. Let me tell you something, I wouldn't pick a church because it was close. I wouldn't pick a church because my buddies went there. I wouldn't pick a church because of the kids program or the youth program or the music program. I pick my church by how much word they're going to give me. I need a real word. I don't know about the rest of y'all, but I don't fight no puppet devils. I don't fight no stick figure demons. I need a real word to be able to break down the attacks that come against me. Let me teach you some more. I ain't got to the good stuff yet. They are opposite. God is light. I am the light of the world. He that follows me shall not walk in darkness. 1 John 1:5. This is the message we have heard of him and declare unto you, that God is light and in him is no darkness at all. Satan's kingdom is darkness. When God saves us, Colossians said, God transfers us from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of his dear son. Now watch what Peter says. We're a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people that should show forth the praises of him who called us out of into marvelous light. God is good. Genesis, it is good. Acts 10:38, Jesus went about doing good. James, every good and perfect gift. Lord have mercy. Anything bad happening in your life, come from the devil. Anything good happening in your life, come from God. Come on, y'all. It don't take rocket science to figure that out. Come on. The devil ain't going to do you nothing but bad, and God ain't going to do you nothing but good. Come on. You need to look at it. If it's good, God sent it. If it's bad, the devil sent it. Some of y'all don't know what to rebuke anymore. You don't know if it's God. You don't know if it's the devil. You need to get educated in the Word of God. And if it's God, hey, let it rock on, baby. But if it's the devil, stand in the gap. Rebuke it in the name of the Lord. Take authority over it. Satan comes to take. He is a thief that comes to steal, kill, and destroy. They are opposite, but they are not equal. You missed a good place to say amen right there. We say up, down, right, wrong, black, white, good, bad, God, devil. Whoop! No. No, 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 no. They are opposite, but they are not equal. Read your Bible. He's the little G God. We serve the big G God. Let me tell you what my daddy told me one time. He said he's the devil, but he's still God's devil. Oh, my God, my God. Don't you know he's on a chain? He's on a leash. He can't do nothing that God won't let him do. I'll teach you something here tonight. The devil, as I said, does not know it all. He does not know it all. And I'll get into it in a moment. He only knows what you tell him. This is killing me. Thank you. I can't stand this anymore. Thank you. Because I didn't know it till you told me. Makes you just want to put duct tape over your mouth and not say nothing to nobody, don't it? Come on, we all in the boat. Satan doesn't know it all. God does. He knows you're down sitting, you're uprising. Look at me. I'm getting there. Satan's not everywhere. God is. Look, look. Satan can't do anything that he wants to do. If he did, you wouldn't be here. Now, in Job, I'm going to prove it all to you. Look. In Job, there's a conversation, chapter 1. Satan comes before God. And God says, "What's up, devil?" Come on, work with me a little, y'all. I ain't trying to take, you know, too much liberty with the Bible by no means, but bring it down to modern vernacular. So God says, "What's up? What you been doing?" "Doing what devils do." "I've been walking around seeking whom I could devour. I've been coming to steal, kill, and destroy." Notice. Satan doesn't bring Job up. God brings Job up. Listen to me. Sometimes God says, "Try my champion. You've been whipping up on everybody else pretty easy. Let me bring out my ringer." Next time the devil comes huffing and puffing trying to blow your house down, you ought to hold your head up, stick your chest out. "God thought enough of me to let me be the one that the enemy wants to fight today." Come on, I know it's hard because we've been taught wrong, but it is a fact that God has a confidence in something in you that he knows the devil may huff and puff, but I'm preaching better than you shout, but he will not blow. Have you considered? Listen, let me tell you something. Listen. Where does lightning strike? Lightning does not strike the shed out in the backyard. Lightning strikes the tall trees. Lightning strikes the skyscrapers downtown Charlotte. And I want to tell you something. The fact that you are going somewhere, the fact that you are strong in the Lord and in the might and in the power of God, the fact that you're rising above your peers in the spirit world, God has set you out front, and he has said, "Try them on for size. See how you like his faith. See how he praises me in the midst of adversity." Everybody else that you've tried, devil has wimped out. But try So watch how it unfolds. God says, try my servant Job. Listen to what the devil says. I've been trying, but I can't get to him. Because you put this hedge. It ain't that I ain't been trying. I've been reaching. I've been knocking. Yeah. But I can't get to him. Because every time I come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord raises up a standard. Every time I bring my weapons and form them, no weapon that I formed against him will prosper. You better hear me. Listen. When this spiritual attack comes, it comes at the permission and the allowance of God. Hear what I'm preaching here tonight. Let me show you this. The Bible would let me know that Job was a success. Watch. 4,500 years ago in the land of Uz, 7,000 sheep, 3,000 camels, 500 yoke of oxen, 500 she-asses, spiritual, a man of integrity, impeccable character. Every day he got up and he offered sacrifices for his children. He was a champion. He was a success. Your success is going to breed some contempt. Let me tell you, not everybody appreciates you getting up and getting on. Not everybody's going to applaud the fact that you ain't walking the floor at night no more. Yeah, when you were having to ride the bus, yeah, they were cool with it, but now that you got a car, they don't know you no more. Very few people are going to be proud of your achievement. Listen to me. Very few people will applaud you, validate you, and even fewer than that are going to take note, observe, and learn by your life. Most of them are intimidated because your success, listen to me, your success is an indictment against their laziness. Because when they look at you, they realize where they could have. I could have been there, but I quit. I could have been there, but I rolled over and played dead. I could have been there, but I took the sissy's way out. And when times got tough, I ran like a baby. I could have been somebody had I had some strength and some stamina. I want to tell you, success intimidates people. I'm going somewhere. No? Listen, look, it doesn't have to be financial success. It can be artistic success. It can be, watch this, spiritual success. When you ain't getting no prayers answered, you got people right there with you when you struggle. But when you start getting some miracles in your life, people will quit calling you. I know from whence I speak, ministerial success. The bigger my church gets, the fewer preacher friends I have. I don't hear nobody in here. Lord. If you're not careful, that spirit will climb up in you. And you will start seeing others with success and victory. And you'll start having these little snide remarks. And then you'll be cupping an attitude and you'll cut off your blessing. You better keep your head down and your mouth shut. But there's somebody else that comes to check you out. The devil is a sore loser. You whip him today, he gonna come back with reinforcements tomorrow. And the Bible said he wants to get after Job, and he seeks permission, and God will grant permission. And I don't want you to be intimidated, because with permission comes provision. With permission comes parameters. Listen. Let me take you to the New Testament. Watch. Simon, Simon, Satan has desired to have you. He couldn't just up and take you. He had to fill out a requisition form. He had to request. Woo. And I gave him permission. What? God don't do me no favors. How many of you feel like that one? Satan has desired to have you that he will sift you as we watch. You know what sifting is? Sifting is when you take it and you toss it up and the wind catches it and carries it away, and it is severed. It is separated. It is detached and disconnected. The devil is not fighting you over where you are. The fight is about where you're going. Ah, my God. Can y'all hear me? Am I loud enough? Look. He at this moment is Simon. He's on his way to becoming Peter. You don't see it. You don't see it. Simon means water. Peter means rock. He said, right now you're Simon, but you're on your way to becoming Peter. Right now you're weak as water, but you're on your way to becoming a rock. So the devil says, if I'm going to get him, I got to get him before he becomes the rock. Given him permission. But watch, watch. When you are converted, not if. Y'all missed it. When you come out, when it turns around, when this is over. Huh? Not if, but when. When you're converted, you're going to have extra strength. You take the strength that you learned through this sifting. God, I can't help it. Then you're going to strengthen your brethren. Watch what he says. He says, and this is how I know you will make it. I have prayed for you. Study it. Jesus didn't say, I'm not praying that you won't be sifted. He said, you're going to be sifted. Huh? He said, I didn't pray that you wouldn't be sifted. He said, I prayed that you would keep your faith, that your faith wouldn't fail. Baby, this is Jesus praying. This ain't Benny Hinn. This ain't Hot Rod Parsley. This is Jesus, the same Jesus that stood outside Lazarus' tomb and said, I know you hear me always. This is a Jesus that never prayed a prayer that God wouldn't answer. He said, I prayed for you. And if Jesus prays for your faith, it won't buckle at the furnace door. If he prays for your faith, it won't collapse at the Red Sea. If he prays for your faith, you'll go into the lion's den and use their mane for a pillow and sleep like a baby. Look at me. I want you to know why you're still here. I want to tell you why you're still here. You ain't here because of your posse. You ain't here because of your prayer club. You ain't here because of your prayer manual. You ain't here because of Bishop Tucker. You're here because, don't you give nobody else credit, you're here because Jesus, who is at the right hand of the Father, has not stopped praying for you. That's why you've been troubled on every side, yet not distressed. That's why you've been perplexed, but not in despair. That's why you were persecuted, but not forsaken. That's why you've been cast down, but you were not destroyed. Don't you hear me? I'm telling you, he prayed something on the inside of you that will take a licking and keep on ticking. Give God a praise in here. So Satan says, if you remove the perimeter, take down the hedge, let me get at him, he'll curse you because he's just serving you for stuff anyway. Stay with me. So let me get my hands on his stuff. Watch what God says. God says, go get his stuff. Huh? The Bible said the Sabians come, kill oxen and asses, fire falls, burns up his sheep, Chaldeans steal his camels, kill his servants, 10 children lay beneath the rubble of a collapsed home. Chapter 1, verse 20, Job rent his mantle, shaved his head, and fell to the ground. But he didn't do what the devil thought he was going to do. He didn't quit. Now chapter 2, the devil comes back and says, God said, what you been doing? What's up, devil? What you been doing? Doing what devils do. How'd it go with Job? He didn't act like I thought he was going to act. I took everything he had. But he's still serving you. But let me touch him. Watch how it gets more personal. Come on, y'all. Gets more pearl. Let me. God said, I tell you what, have at him. You can touch him personally, but you can't kill him. I'm going to draw a line. Now, he might have wished he was dead. Huh? But God said, I'm drawing a line, and you can't kill him. Some stuff God keeps you from. Some stuff you just endure. We don't get to escape everything, y'all. Come on, how many of you know that's true? You don't get to escape everything. Yeah, there's some stuff God keeps me from, but some stuff God just keeps me through. Chapter 2, verse 7. So now Job is smitten with boils. He sits on an ash heap and he scrapes them. His wife said, man, you on your way out, honey. This ain't looking good. And why don't we, if you go ahead and curse God, maybe God will take you out quicker and you ain't got to just sit here and just suffer a long time. And he said, you talk like a heathen, unconverted woman. Watch what happens. The Bible says he falls on the ground and worships. Three things. Watch. I gave you the last verse, last two verses of the book. He come back. He lived four generations after the trouble. I'm going to show you three things fast. Three things you better learn in the midst of the fight. This is how you turn it around. You got to learn how to worship through the worst. Anybody can worship when the bills are paid. Anybody can worship when you got a clean bill of health. Anybody can worship when your marriage is still in the honeymoon phase. Anybody can worship when the kids are behaving and bringing home straight A's. Looks like they're going to get a scholarship to their favorite college. But I want to know, can you worship when life ain't making no sense at all? Oh! Sometimes God allows this to find out where your worship is. Because anybody can worship when you're on the top, but can you worship when you're on the bottom? Can you worship? Anybody can worship when they abound, but can you worship when you obey? See, anybody can worship when they're full, but can you worship when you're empty? Anybody can worship when Brother Chris or Brother Douglas, when they are playing and Brandon's beating the drum and somebody's shaking the tambourine and the place is full on Sunday morning. Anybody, even a hypocrite, can come in and fake it till they make it. But God wants to know, can you be without friends? Can your body be racked with pain? Can you be alone, abandoned, forsaken? Can you walk the floor in agony? Can you shed a bucket of tears and yet be like Job and say, whether the Lord gives or whether the Lord takes away, I'll be here speaking good. I will eulogize. I will bless. He said, I'm going to say the same thing about God when I'm down that I was saying when I was up. I'll say the same thing when I'm broke as I said when I had money. Times change, but God doesn't ever change. You hear me? There's gonna come a time you're gonna have to prove to the devil you ain't worshiping God for stuff. Kissing up to God for promotions. It ain't about CDs. It ain't about your investments. It's not about promotion. It's about I love him regardless of the way life is unfolding in my life. Job said, I didn't have anything when I got here. Naked I came into the world. Naked, he said, when I showed up, I didn't have anything at the cradle. And there ain't going to be no U-Haul behind the hearse. Come on. He said, I didn't have anything when I got here. I may not have anything when I leave. He said, but I'm going to praise God. Listen to me, man. Don't you ever push pause on your praise. Sometimes it is your praise that turns the tide of battle. Just ask Jehoshaphat, who began to talk about the mercy of God. If you don't think so, ask Paul and Silas in the midnight hour, and they'll tell you that praise turned everything around. It caused freedom when there was captivity. Right now, you need to praise God for holding you. You need to praise God for choosing you. You need to praise God for not losing you. You need to praise God for using you. You need to praise God that he walked with you through thick and thin. You need to praise God that he kept you from being suicidal. He kept you from going insane. He rocked you in the cradle of his love. And when nothing else would help, his love lifted you. Number two, showing you how to turn it. Number two, Job kept his character in check. In all this, Job sinned not nor charged God foolishly. His friends Eliphaz, Bildad, Zophar, Elihu came. Boy, with friends like that, you don't need enemies. They sit and just stare at him for a week. Read your Bible. They didn't say a word. They just sit there and looked at him. Finally, they started speaking up and said, well, the reason you're in this mess, you must have fooled around somewhere. You must have somebody on the side. You know God's just getting even with you, don't you? You know this is the justice and the judgment of God being meted out. Listen, the test will reveal what you're made of. We don't know what's in you until you're being squeezed. If I squeeze an apple, I get apple juice. If I squeeze an orange, I get orange juice. If I squeeze a lemon, I get lemon juice. If I squeeze a prune, I get prune juice. Ask your neighbor, what's God been getting out of you? Help me, Jesus. You don't know what you're made of. Oh, you can talk all you want to talk. But when you're in the vice and being squeezed, we're going to know what you're made of. Are you here? Watch. Job said, I thought I had it together. He said, I thought I was in my nest egg, if you will. He said, I thought I had achieved a place of safety and security. I'd climbed to the apex, the zenith, the pinnacle of success. He said, I thought I could put life on cruise control and take it easy the rest of my days. I'd raised 10 kids. I had a thriving business. Everything was good. He said, and then it all changed. Look at me, brothers and sisters. It can all change overnight. One phone call, everything changes. Some stuff we bring on ourselves. Others, we are just innocent bystanders. You didn't have anything to do about it or with it. Somebody decides they want to cut back. You're tired of paying big salaries, and now you're expendable. And watch what relationships can change up on you. I know right now he's lover boy. He'll turn into Frankenstein's monster. I know right now she's sweet thing. Better watch her. She'll turn into Medea. People will change. Situations will change. Listen to me. One sickness, one surgery. Come on. One setback, one infection. Come on. Help me. Help me. Help me. Help me. And here you are in the poorhouse. Spin up all your 401k. Went into your retirement fund. And here you are living on nickels and dimes. Life will change on you. You better stay rooted. Come on, watch, 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 watch. Job said, one day I was walking through the woods and I looked down and I saw a stump. He said there wasn't nothing left. He said, but through the scent of water, because the roots ran deep, because the roots could reach the water. He said, I saw a tree growing back. Oh, my God. The devil will cut you down. He will strip the leaves off of your limbs. He will saw them off. He will cut you down. We'll call you stumpy. But listen, if your roots will run deep enough, you will come back. Anybody know what I'm talking about? Listen here. Some of you ain't been getting it all back in bunches. It's a little here and it's a little there. Here a word, there a word. Yeah, come on, somebody. But guess what? Look back over your life. Because you had deep roots, you didn't get swallowed up. You didn't get chewed up and spit out. You are still here and you will bounce. I don't worry about you. You're going to make it. Some on boards and some on broken pieces. Because because you're still rooted. And if the root runs deep enough, I'll start seeing fruit back on the tree. Lean over and tell somebody, I'm still rooted. I ain't got no job, but I'm still rooted. I ain't got much of a family left, but I am still rooted. My health ain't what it used to be, but I'm still rooted. And because I'm rooted, I'm on my way back. Somebody raise your hand and say, I'm on my way back. Number one, he worshipped in the worst. Number two, he kept his integrity. Number three, he kept a positive confession of faith. We're just about there. Look, chapter 2 and verse 10. In all this, Job sinned not with his lips. God had me going back and digging up some verses for you. Look at this. Proverbs 6 and 2, you're snared by the words of your mouth. It's not what you say about me that snares me. It's what I say. The devil cannot use your words against me. I don't hear you. But he will use my words. Psalm 77, verse 3. I complained and my spirit was overwhelmed. Y'all writing this down? Proverbs 18:7, a fool's mouth is his destruction. You know this, when death and life are in the tongue. Jesus said, you'll have whatsoever you say. 1 Peter 3:10, for he that will love life and see good days. How many of you want to see some good days? Then refrain your tongue from evil and your lips from speaking guile. Satan is not everywhere, but he has a network of demons that are eavesdropping. Listen to me. I'm almost finished. Listening to our conversations. Let me show it to you. Ecclesiastes 10 and 20. Curse not the king. No, not in thy thought. Curse not the rich in thy bedchamber. For a bird, somebody say bird, a bird of the air shall carry the voice. And that which has wings shall tell the matter. Let me explain something to you. Listen to me carefully. Heard that little saying, a little bird told me? Right there. But watch. In the scripture, fowl are demonic spirits. The sower sowed seed and fowl took. Come on, watch. Revelation talks about every hateful bird and foul spirit. Watch. The devil cannot read our minds, but he listens to our conversations. And then he will take the words out of our mouth and formulate a plan. Let me show you. I'm afraid I'll never get a job. Then he turns that fear into a weapon. Then you get a job. I'm afraid I can't keep my job. Then he turns that into a weapon. And he uses your fears against you. But he didn't know what your fears were until you identified. You informed. You educated your adversary. Come on, watch. Jesus said to his disciples, listen to me, I'm teaching you tonight. He said, he's in the garden. He said, the prince of this world cometh, but hath nothing in me. Watch. He said, henceforth I will not speak with you. He said, I'm not going to be talking to you anymore. He said, the devil doesn't have anything in me. He said, and the only thing he's going to know is what I'm going to tell him. And I'm not telling you anything, because if I tell you, he's going to hear. There are some things that we need to put up under our feet. There's some speech and some language. All of us. I can't take it no more. I can't stand it. Help me, God. Come on. Even Jesus said, you'll have whatsoever you say. Look, here it is. I'm about there. We ought to be walking around saying, I am the head and not the tail. I don't care if you do feel like a tail. You need to say you're the head. The head and not the tail, above and not beneath. I'm blessed. I don't care if you feel so rotten until you stink. I am blessed. I'm more than a conqueror. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Here we go. Here it is. Last thing. Chapter 42. Bible says after this. Somebody say after this. Which means this ain't the end. After this, Job lived 140 years. How many times have we thought our life was over because of a situation? Well, this is it. My world is crashing. And I understand at the moment we sort of feel that. And I'm not trying to deny people their feeling and their emotion. But there is an after this. I'm going to say this and I'm going to close it down. Look. If you think for one moment that manna from heaven is all there is. If you think for one moment that water coming out of the flinty rock is all that God can do. If you think for one moment that all you're going to get out of this battle is bitter waters turned sweet, you're selling God short. The reason that you are fighting giants and having to march around walls is because there is a bread without scarceness that you're going to eat. There's a land flowing with milk and honey. Come on, there's pomegranates. Listen to me. Some of you think that is some great big thing that you bought $45 worth of groceries for $30 cash. I appreciate that, but that ain't all God's going to do for you. There is some, listen, because the Bible said your latter shall be greater and the end of the thing better than the beginning. The glory of the latter house. Look at Job's life. The glory of his latter house was, I want to tell the devil, I know you think there's going to be a funeral, but not today. Put your black suit back in the closet. Take all the flowers back to the florist. Get a refund on your card. There ain't going to be no funeral today. I'm not going to die in this battle. This ain't the end of me. I will come back. I will come back better. Job said, I'm going to come back like pure gold. Devil, you will pay for this. I want you to stand all over the house. You will pay for this. You will pay for this. God ain't gonna let me be bullied for nothing. When I get through this, I'll have a greater faith. When I get through this, I'll have a greater anointing on my life. When I get through this, I'll have a greater appreciation for the sovereignty of God. When I get through this. Somebody just raise your hand and say, God, I know this is not all there is. Come on, I'm playing on the word this. Somebody say, this is not the end. There's got to be more than this. After this. Man, devil, if you hated me before this, wait till you see me after this. Devil, you tried to disconnect and you tried to sever our destiny. You tried to so overwhelm us until you thought we would walk out. You know why I don't worry about y'all? Because you could have stayed at home tonight. And God knows some did. But you come up on here, in here anyway. You didn't feel like it, but you came on. You felt like crying, but you sang through the praise and worship. Ah, shokabahai. Oh, yeah. You don't even feel like standing out, but you're standing because those over you in the Lord ask you to stand. You know what? I ain't worried about you. You are what I call super balls. Man, I used to get a Super Bowl every time Mom and Daddy took me out. Y'all know them little Super Bowls. You know the great thing about a Super Bowl is, The harder you throw it, the higher it bounces. Some of you don't know it, but the harder the devil hits you, the higher God's going to take you. That's the word right there for somebody. Raise your hand right now and say, the harder the devil hits me, the higher God's going to take me. Listen, I feel led of the Holy Ghost to tell you, this is your proving ground right now. God's testing you to see what you're made of. God's testing you to see if you can pass the test or not. He's testing you to see if you're serving Him for loaves or fishes, or you're serving Him for who He is. He's testing you. He's allowing this to see if you're going to run or if you're going to stand, if you're going to bow or if you're going to burn. He's testing. He's allowing you to be tested. Some of you are coming through this with good marks. You're passing with flying colors. It hasn't been easy for you. It's been hard. As we say, a hard road to hoe. But you kept singing the praises of God in the midnight hour. You kept quoting scripture. You kept standing on the promises of God. You kept walking by faith and not by sight. You prayed when you couldn't feel a tug on the other end of the line. God's going to reward you handsomely. I'm going to tell you one thing that has sustained me through the course of 2 years and almost 6 months. He that cometh to God must believe that He is a rewarder of them that diligently seek Him. I know God will reward our diligence and our prayers. I'm going to ask you to gather with me around this altar, if you would, right now. I want to pray for you. Come on, join me. I'm not going to hold you long. I know we've got some other activity scheduled, but I want to impart something into you tonight. Some of you for where you are, others for where you're about to be. Yeah. Oh, God. Look at me. Sometimes you don't even know what you made out of. Come on. Listen. Usually, we grade everybody else real strict, but we grade ourselves on a curve. You know what that means? That means we usually think more highly of ourselves than we should. You know, we usually think, I'm stronger than anybody else. I'm more holy than anybody else. We, not y'all, them other people I pastor. I got more joy than anybody else. But then, when the trouble comes, you realize where you really do stand. Sometimes it exposes your deficiencies. I'm short on this, but sometimes it will expose your strength. And you'll look at yourself and say, I didn't know I had it in me. I didn't know I could take this 2 years and almost 6 months. I hadn't wanted to, but I took it. Sometimes you find out you can take what you didn't want to take and stand what you didn't want to stand. The only way you get to learn that about yourself is for God to allow you to go through the test. How many of you right now say, preacher, I believe I'm going through a severe test. I'm not talking about so-and-so didn't shake my hand. Don't even waste my time with that. Come on. So-and-so didn't like my Facebook post. Don't waste my time for that. I'm talking about how many of you going through something. I mean, really going through something. He's attacking your mind. He's attacking your faith. He is attacking your health. He's attacking relationships. Raise your hand. I'm going to ask you three questions. Can you worship through the worst of it? Can you worship when the doctor says, I've done all I know to do, like you were worshiping when you had a clean bill of health? I know it's hard, and God knows I don't want to have to try. But but you got to worship through your darkest day. You're going to keep your character and integrity. You're not going to accuse God of being unfair and unjust. Number three, are you going to keep your faith firm? You're going to keep a positive, then you will come out of it. Raise your hands and I want to pray for you. Father, these are your children. For some, I really believe with all of my heart, this is a life or death struggle. And when I say that, I'm not talking about in the natural, I'm talking about in the spiritual. It is a struggle for eternal life or eternal death. You're not just attacking them. The enemy is not just attacking them to make life inconvenient or worrisome or troublesome. He's after you to break you. I feel him. The devil's trying to break you down, but you're going to make it. God said, tell them the same spirit that brought my son out of the tomb lives in them. Somebody needs to take that right now. Raise your hand. The same spirit. There's a resurrection overcoming anointing on your life. God, I feel it in this house. Somebody praise him right now. Yeah. They might pronounce you over and done with. They might roll a stone in front of you, but you will come out. Yeah. Come on, praise him all over the house. I feel it released in the room. The same spirit. Come on, celebrate it right now. Celebrate it. You're more than a conqueror. If God before you, nobody can be against you. Come on, everybody, right now, just worship him. Love him. I feel strength in the room. You will survive it. Come on, say it to yourself. I will survive it. I will outlast it. I will outlive it. Yeah, you better talk to it. You got to learn to talk to things that don't have ears. You got to learn to talk to mountains and curse fig trees. You got to learn to speak it. I will survive this. I hear the Lord say to me, listen, I hear the Lord telling me to tell you right now, it's as though your whole life depends on this moment, but it doesn't. Listen to me, it doesn't. This is just part of your whole life. When this is over, you're going to just put a little asterisk by this. Yeah, I remember it, but I went on. I cried, but I went on. I couldn't eat. He took my appetite. I couldn't sleep, but I went on. Oh, my. Sometimes you just got to keep on walking. I've been feeling that in my spirit for 2 weeks. And I've been praying it over myself. Sometime you got to walk on. Victory's not behind you. Victory's ahead of you. If you sit down, if you quit, you don't ever get it. But you got to keep on pressing. I said you got to keep on pressing. You got to keep on keeping on. You got to keep on pressing. Come on, tell your neighbor, keep on walking. Keep on walking. You got to walk out of it. Walk out of this and walk into that. Walk out of this and walk into that. Walk out of this level and walk into the next level. I'm hearing the word of the Lord clearly. God said, tell him you walked out of May into June. And you're about to walk out of June into July. The same power that brought you from May to June is taking you from June to July. It'll take you from July to August. Hey, yeah, 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 yeah. Come on, come on, come on. Hey, I know in whom I believe. I know. Come on, I want you just to raise your hands right now. Just look into the face of the Father. Thank Him for keeping you. Thank Him for His strength. I don't always understand Him. There have been many days I hadn't understood Him. But I believe Him when I don't understand Him. My, 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 my. When my mind, listen, God said, tell them, when your mind is saying no, have a yes in your spirit. I don't know who that's for. When your mind is telling you no, you got to have a yes in your spirit. Yes, there is a way. Yes, there is an answer. Yes, there is a God. Yes, there is a sign and a wonder. Yes, there will be another day. Yes, I will smile again. I got to say it this way. Yes, I will shout again. Yes, I will dance again. Weeping endures for the night. But yes, joy comes in the morning. My head's telling me no. But there's a yes in my spirit. Don't let your head talk you out of what your spirit's trying to talk you into. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. I feel a yes in me right here. Come on, I dare you to lay your hand on your belly, on your chest, and say, there's a yes in here. There's a yes in here. The devil took a lot of stuff, but he didn't get my yes. Oh, my God, my God, my God, my God. Oh, he didn't get my yes. There's still a yes to the promises of God. The devil took things. He took people. People came and people left. But God safeguarded my yes. Well, go ahead. You deserve it. Go ahead, Brother Van. You deserve it, brother. Yeah, yeah, la 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 bo shake. Oh, la 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 my Monday. I feel it in the house. Keshake babo shake. Tala la de bo say. My Monday do bo repaye. Oh, my God, my God, my God. Hallelujah. 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 Go ahead. You're entitled. I'll clear the church if I have to let you shout. You're entitled. You're entitled. It cost you to get this shout tonight. It cost you to get this blessing. We're going to let you obey God. Yes. 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 Can you raise your hand and thank God for a word tonight that you can sink your teeth into? Maybe it wasn't the prettiest word you've ever gotten. Maybe not the most eloquent and most polished, but I'm going to tell you, this will get you through some tough times. Minister Matthew's going to come, and I want you to stay and engage the presence of God. Listen, we'll get back there when the time is right. But let me tell you, I purpose in my heart, and I've honored this before God and you, that I will not bring you anything that I don't believe will work in your life. In fact, I won't preach anything to you that I'm not convinced works for me. Okay? And if I've seen it